These guys know I'm not playing. Then what's happening? You know, you guys don't have confidence in yourself.
I'm the one. He bring nothing to the table for me. I don't need to prove anything to anybody anymore. I've been done everything in my career.
Canelo Alvarez.
He's nothing to offer me. Anything.
What the hell are you talking about? Will you stop? That's just BS.
He hecho mucha historia. Estoy muy orgulloso, ¿no? Pero que he logrado.
He wants to be considered one of the all-time greats, period.
Anybody who knows boxing, everybody who watches boxing knows that David Benavidez is the real deal.
The Mexican monster.
Reaching the summit of success at the pinnacle of the sport puts a target on your back, attracting hungry contenders eager to prove themselves as the best to both themselves and to the world. Canelo Alvarez, a titan of the ring, has been immersed in the world of professional boxing since the tender age of 15. With multiple world titles across four distinct weight classes under his belt, he remains an undisputed force and undeniably one of the greatest boxers of all time. One standout figure in the super middleweight division is David Benavidez, recently given the alias The Monster by Mike Tyson.
We are underway.
So I'm saying there's excuse after excuse after excuse. Bro, he doesn't want to fight.
You know what this is. Stick up. Give me the dough from your pickup. She ran into the wrong.
And they call him some bitches. Say something else.
Yeah. And I will hurt him too, and I'll take all his belts. Now, I want what's rightfully mine. I earned my opportunity to fight for those belts, and he should fight me. Yeah. A lot of the greats that are still here with us today are saying that's the best fight that could be made. Fight, bro. Everybody wants to see that fight.
White boy in the wrong place at the right time.
150 to 200 million. I fight tomorrow.
Payday, you want payday.
Maybe after he gets that money, he can buy himself a pair of balls. You know what I mean? Because.
Nigga, get the phone book, look up in the yellow page. Let me tell you how we're gonna get.
I'm gonna get paid, my nigga.
Hell yeah.
Ain't you tired of starving, my nigga?
Hey, you fight with nobody, man.
Hell yeah.
Get the fuck out of here, man.
We want to see Benavidez. Canelo, hell of a fighter, but my personal opinion, he's ducking Benavidez. Mm. We want to see Benavidez.
I started boxing like around 2 years old.
Benavidez is 6'2", and he's never fought at a weight lower than 167 pounds in his career. He is 28-0 with 24 KOs. Benavidez is coming off a destructive victory over the previously undefeated Demetrius Andrade.
Right in the face of Andrade, and definitely heard him put him down. The power of David Benavidez.
Preceded by a unanimous decision win over former 168-pound champion Caleb Plant. Stylistically and physically, Benavidez looks like an opponent who could create serious issues for Canelo. Perhaps that's why Canelo didn't choose to face him next despite the public outcry for the fight. To Canelo's point, he has fought everyone you could imagine, from 154 to 175 pounds up to this point. You could argue he has earned the right to be picky at this career stage.
On the chin, I saw
Canelo. Let's get the people what they want to see. They want to see David versus Benavidez versus Canelo. That says enough on the song right there.
We know who you are, Canelo. You big time. The boxing world, Canelo Alvarez, has been asking you to go in the ring against David Benavidez, who's undefeated, a knockout artist, has smoked everybody in his path. He's undefeated, and he's been asking for you.
Yeah, champ, thank you for coming.
It's crazy that he asked for 150 million or 200 million to fight me, but he still has the nerve to say that I don't bring nothing to the table. So if I didn't bring nothing to the table, why are you asking for more money than you won in your whole career?
If I'm Canelo Alvarez and I'm gonna risk my reputation and my
my record and my physical well-being against a puncher like that. I want to be paid for it. That's point one. Point two is he's sending a signal to the audience with that. Look at the money I need to be paid to get into the ring to fight this guy. This is how meaningful I think the combat is.
There's a lot of ways to say no. You fought the greatest Mexican army of all time. You fought his son, and now you got another Mexican over here that you don't want to fight?
When you have excuses, you know, I'm not saying you're afraid, you know, kind of like, you know, but fighters know who you can beat or who you cannot beat.
In boxing, they play this dodgeball game. Oh, I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. I don't want to fight. Man, get out of here with that.
It's came to see a Mexican showdown, a Mexican.
Well, how you gonna tell me after you done beat Julio Cesar Chavez that you don't fight Mexicans? Nah, bro, we ain't buying that.
It's a master class from Alvarez, and they know for sure now who the star of Mexico is.
Well, that sounds like he don't want to fight my son in a sense. So I agree with him in that aspect. I'll be like, nah, bro, you fought his son, you fought the greatest Mexican of all time. You fought his son, why you can't fight my son? Because my son might be better than his son was. Oh, now you gonna fight Mexicans? Ah, nah, bro, nah.
Please.
Supposed to be, we trying to find out who the baddest MF of all times is. You understand me?
I'm gonna respect myself. Please, guys.
You put a place your bid while you got the opportunity to. I don't give a damn who out there. You go place that bid against him. You understand me? I had to go out in heavyweight to place my bid. But I did that. I want to show the world that I'm gonna go do something that ain't nobody never did.
I really do think he's scared of me.
When I say I don't wanna fight Mexican, it's because I represent Mexico. And that's why. But I don't care. I fight anybody. And I fight all my entire life anybody. What do you think? I don't wanna fight with Juan Mexico or Benavidez.
Well, if I talk so much shit, come shut me up. He's getting a good paycheck for it. Go fucking shut me up.
With fear looming around Canelo's name and fans clamoring an all-out Mexican scuffle between Saul Alvarez and David Benavidez, Canelo seems pressured and could bring this fight to the ring.
But look. I hear his dad talking a lot of shit.
No, he doesn't want to fight David. You seen the ridiculous amount of money that he asked for. Who's going to pay him $200 million, you know? There's no way, you know? What does that tell you? You know, he says David doesn't bring anything to the table, only 25 pounds on the day of the fight. How many pounds is he going to bring to the day of the fight also? But at the end of the day, he's only looking for excuses. David's been the mandatory for 3 years.
But look, what he's... Look, he's accomplished nothing. One single champion, Anthony Derrell.
As a fighter in the boxing game, proving the fans with the competition they want to see is where the money is. With that said, Canelo cannot avoid this fight as it will stain his reputation and legacy.
We haven't seen an all-Mexican showdown at an elite level since Eric Morales, Barrera, Marquez.
For the simple fact that he's asking for 150, 200 million, like, come on, bro, like, that's... And he continues to say, I'm not worth anything. It's funny that you're gonna ask $200 million for a fighter who's not worth anything.
Mm.
You know what I mean? So take me out of the equation. There's not... Him asking for that amount is not realistic.
Right. The 168-pound division is stacked. It is exciting. And Benavidez deserves a world title opportunity. He's been waiting in line for, I don't know how long. So there's a lot of players now at 168. Benavidez, I love. His style is incredible. He's an amazing, amazing fighter. I love his attitude. I love what he represents. I love his work ethic. He deserves a shot. And right now, Canelo Alvarez is the king. And the king has to decide. But like I said before, the media can help.
You know, Oscar's just a clown, and everyone knows that. And that's why nobody deals with him. He's a horrible, horrible person.
The fans can help and decide what Canelo's next fight should be. Look, Benavidez, who I respect a lot, incredible, incredible talent. He's been the mandatory for Canelo for almost 2 years, I believe. So it's all politics. And things have to change.
Canelo Alvarez is not scared of David Benavidez. That's not true. That's not true. No matter what the perception looks like, that man ain't scared. The fighters fight. Again, he knows what he's doing.
Because I come from an era, so does Hopkins, where you fight everybody. You You fight the best. You fight whoever you fight. You have to fight.
I think when they fight, it's going to be a terrific fight. It's going, at that point in time, it'll be the biggest fight in all of boxing.
It has to stop.
The big question is Benavidez's chin. It's untested. Andrade was on survival mode most of the fight. And Plant isn't the hardest hitters. The fight previous was with a way over the hill Lemieux. He was dropped by Garble, but doesn't mean he's got a bad chin, sometimes that just happens. Benavidez's footwork ain't looked that great, he only moves in straight lines, he's massive for the weight and has missed weight before, which looks as if he struggles getting down to 168, and we haven't seen him sustain a body attack, and with the height difference, you'd think that'd be Canelo's target.
The reason people want to see Canelo Alvarez against David Benavidez is because they want to see risk. That's what sells prize fights. Most people who follow boxing don't really think that Canelo is risking anything against Jaime Munguia because they don't believe that Munguia is skilled enough to find him often enough to get that done. They do believe that Benavidez might be skilled enough to find him. And if Benavidez were to go into the ring with Canelo and find him, that chin might not matter because Benavidez has epic power. He has the kind of punching power that, you know, you go to sleep at night thinking, oh my gosh, I'm not sure where I've seen that before. He detonated Demetrius Andrade, blew him up. And I thought Andrade, because of his craft, was more or less knockout proof. When have I seen the kind of explosive power that David Benavidez just showed me? Lennox Lewis, Mike Tyson. Those are the kinds of fighters who demonstrated that kind of power.
He wanted from David. What do you think about Canelo said if he wanted to fight him to give him $150 million.
That's his price. Look, that's Canelo's price. That tells you how much he thinks of Benavidez, in my opinion. That's what it thinks. He thinks of Benavidez as one of those guys.
Hey, my respect for everybody, okay? Good fight. Thank you.
If Canelo fights and beats Benavidez and Morel, then that pretty much silences all critiques. Massive defenses against real 168ers confirms that he is a legit undisputed at 168 division. Canelo defeating Munguia could indeed be seen as a stay busy fight, particularly considering Munguia's relative lack of experience compared to Canelo's status as one of the top pound for pound boxers in the world. While such fights may help Canelo maintain activity in between more significant bouts, they may not necessarily add much to his legacy in terms of facing top-tier opposition. Repeatedly facing opponents who are perceived as significantly lesser competition could potentially blemish Canelo's legacy, as it may raise questions about the caliber of opponents he chooses to face. Legacy in boxing is often built on facing and defeating top-level competition, and while every fighter is entitled to some stay-busy fights, an excess of them could diminish the overall perception of Canelo's career achievements.
Yeah, I reach my buckler, madness, yeah. Fully out there and then fierce.
Canelo Alvarez, dog, you know, they say face of boxing, like you and him, that's the biggest fight in boxing.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the biggest fight in boxing. He came out and said, I need $200 million to get in that ring. When you saw that, what was your thoughts?
So it was just funny to me, but honestly, it didn't surprise me. I think it's just funny the way, you know, he said that he needed $200 million. So I just said what everybody was thinking. Hopefully he can buy himself a pair of balls after he makes that money.
Ah, yeah. Can't even spare no force for them. I'm close to the edge of
water there. Man, a man, make sure you don't walk again. If you think that you can beat David, you know, why don't you come and shut me up, you know? I mean, fight him. But what it is, he's scared of fighting David Benavidez, you know? And that's what it is, you know? If David was so easy, he wouldn't care if it was Mexican, black, or whatever. But he knows that David's stronger, he's bigger, and he's hungrier, you know?
Lack of respect means back of his helmet. 100% man who handled the garbage. Handled them dogs, swang through the darkness. Rams in the jar, touched him up, he stuck his neck. Hands on my heart, strangled up. When we put a work on a man, then we're gone.
To truly solidify his legacy as one of the all-time greats, Canelo will likely need to continue facing and defeating the best opponents available in his weight class, demonstrating his skills and dominance against elite competition. While stay busy, fights can serve a purpose in a boxer's career. They should be balanced with high-profile matchups that showcase Canelo's abilities against the best in the sport. Thanks for watching Boxing Star's Tale of the Fight. Please like, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to leave your comment. Goodbye.